So you want to learn how property wrappers work in Swift, but you don't have a lot of time? In just a few minutes, we'll go over everything you need to understand how this powerful feature works. Let's start with this piece of code. As you can see, I've made the mistake of adding an extra white space at the end of the URL. And this small mistake actually has big consequences. Because of it, my URL is not considered valid. That's frustrating, because such small mistakes can happen very easily, especially if our app fetches URLs from a remote configuration service. So wouldn't it be nice if we had a mechanism to wrap our property around some logic that would always trim any extra white spaces? As you can imagine, this is where a property wrapper comes into play. So let's implement a property wrapper in 5 easy steps. Step 1, we create a new struct called trimmed. Step 2, we annotate that struct with @propertywrapper. Step 3, we implement a wrap value with our business logic. Step 4, we implement an initializer. Step 5, we use our new property wrapper. And that's it, we've covered the basics of how a property wrapper works in Swift. Thanks to this feature, we are able to easily wrap a property around a layer of business logic that's guaranteed to be called whenever we use the property. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Remember to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss the next one. Thank you for watching and see you next time.